Well, hello there! Welcome to the update! Sorry, I don't know where that bit of silliness came from. Hiya. It's been a month since I did the last video. It's been 2 weeks since the text update, as is the new way of things. Yeah, it means that I don't get to talk to you guys quite as much as I'd like to, actually. But it does mean that I'm getting stuff done, which is kind of cool. I'm kind of the reason that I cut back a little bit on these videos. So, what exactly have I been getting done? Well, I'll tell you. Well, last week started quite easy for me, really. Basically, my partner Joe has been burning the candle at both ends of it at work and needed a holiday. Not an actual holiday away from home, just a week off, basically. I'm covered in sandwich crumbs. I do apologise. I'm eating my lunch while I'm doing this. So, yeah, she took a week off work just to hang around the house and generally vegetate. And I don't blame her. And she pointed out that I was a little bit tired too, a little bit run down. And she was quite right. So she insisted that I take a couple of days off myself and come and join her on the couch, which is pretty much what I did. We took the dogs to the beach and we tidied the house a bit. We did a bit of gardening. You know, we chilled out and that was nice. And I came back to it feeling a bit better for it. So thanks, Joe. On Wednesday, I got back to it. Now, first of all, before we go on to Flix, I've been dealing with PowerUp iOS and basically having a good play of it on an emulator, which really limits how you can play it because it's a touchscreen game on an iOS device. But getting a feel for the things that are really wrong with the iOS version, basically making a first rough list of things that need fixing before we send it to testing. It'd be a waste of time getting testers to say this is wrong when I know that's wrong. So 2Bit is dealing with that now, that list. As he tells me, he's a bit busy because he's also committed to a few other projects, and that's fine by me. That's how these things are if you can't really afford to pay people properly and you get your friends involved. So that's cool. We were hoping to have it done kind of late summer, but you know, life gets in the way when it's not a paying job, and we're hoping to have the iOS version up and running around the end of October. It's looking like at the moment. As I say, it's not set in stone. It depends on when 2Bit is available and stuff like that. So, when he gets back to me about those fixes, I'll be probably hitting the game again and making another list. But I'm waiting on him to finish his other commitments now before he goes back to PowerUp iOS. So I'll keep you posted on that. My Kickstarter backers will know that I have promised Kickstarter rewards for Flix the Flea by the end of July, which is just over a week away. So, I've had quite a lot to do. Mainly, this game's soundtrack needed to be finished properly in FLAC and MP3 format, and obviously this was stuff I covered in the last update. That was done then. One thing that wasn't done was the signed posters. They are now in envelopes over there, but if you've been following my Twitter feed, you'll have probably seen a big pile of posters on my desk. They're all ready to go. The only issue with the posters is money. I need to wait till I get paid before I can send these posters off. So they'll be going last day of the month, Tuesday, is that next Tuesday? Something like that. So they'll be with you in just over a week, sort of. What you should have before that is those who bought into the soundtrack should have the soundtrack. And everyone who put money into the project will be getting a copy of the game because it's not quite on the scale of PowerUp. It's taken me less time to do, so I'm not going to charge as much for it. I also started it before I started PowerUp, so it's kind of built on a foundation of less skill than PowerUp was. My next game won't be, by the way. My next game's going to be probably bigger. But the game is the main thing, obviously, for Flix the Flea. And getting it finished and ready to go has been my priority in this last week. So basically, I gave myself 2 pages of bugs and improvements. Bugs to fix and improvements to make to the game. And I have covered, in the last week, 3/4 of that lot. There's half a page left of jobs to do. So yeah, last week, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and a little bit of the evenings was spent fixing a large selection of bugs in Flix the Flea, and also making a lot of improvements to it. There's a few big jobs left to do, and I've left them for this week. Which brings us nicely to this week. Okay, so I'll be first and foremost, I'll be finishing that bug list. There's about 10 big, it's not a bug list even, that bugs and improvements list. There's, yeah, about 10 big issues to sort out. I'll be getting started on that today, after this. And I'm hoping to get through at least two a day, because that will have me finished on Friday. But I want to be finished before Friday so I can get the whole thing packaged up with a bow and get it out to everyone. I'm actually hoping to have Flix ready and sent out by Friday afternoon this week. It'll be hot off the press, but it might go right to the wire, this one, with regards to the end of the month. Just because there's stuff to do still. So there's a chance it might be sent out early next week, but I'm hoping it'll be Friday this week. Now, that bug list includes things like, I've got a big list in front of me here, and they are major jobs. It's things like, I prepared the whole loading system for the game that loads and unloads as it needs and doesn't need things. But since then, I've added a lot of sound effects, quite a lot of new graphics, and particularly the game's music, which all needs to be incorporated into the loading system. Because at the moment, Director's great, it loads things as it needs it, but sometimes that is while you're playing the game, and what you don't want is a music track loading up while you're playing the game. So I've got to rehash the loading system, which is quite a big deal. I'm having a few playback issues with sound effects, and it's just formatting problems, really, the way I'm saving the mouse and things like that. I've just got to get my head around the optimum way to do it with large sound effects and with small sound effects. About 60% of the game's sounds are playing at double speed in the built version of the game. They don't do it within the director environment, but when you build the game, they do. So I'll be looking into what's causing that, and hopefully that'll be an afternoon's work. Once I've figured it out, I'll just be able to apply those kind of fixes to pretty much all the sound. I'll also be finalising the game's credits, you know, the logos and your names and things like that for the list of Kickstarter backers. It's pretty much done. There's just a couple that needed a bit of finalising, basically. As I get that information through over the week, I'll be touching that up as well. And the big one, really, that I really want to do, and as I say, this might be the thing that drives the game right to the wire, is I want to add an Easter egg to the game, a few little hidden features, you know, that you can put the extra effort in and achieve. As I say, it's a smaller game than PowerUp, and PowerUp only really saves a score and unlockable spaceships. And I want Flix to do something similar to that, so I won't be pushing the envelope that far with it. But I do want some kind of achievement for people who persevere and play the game more, and, you know, want more out of it. So I'm gonna put a bit of work into making that happen. And as I say, that might push the game a little bit into next week, but we'll see. I think it'll be worth it either way. Yeah, so that's pretty much what I'm doing this coming week. Once the game is built and sent to my Kickstarter backers, and the soundtrack, which is done, is sent to my Kickstarter backers, and the posters, which are done, are sent to my Kickstarter backers, I can consider Flix pretty much commitments met, which is kind of nice. I'll be then turning my attention to what comes next, and over the next month, my big job is to get PowerUp onto Steam. As I mentioned a fortnight ago, I'm going to be putting August into figuring out if I can have Steam awards and whatnot in PowerUp, which would be cool. And if I can do it, I'll find a way within that month. And if I can't, by the end of the month, I'll release the game as is, maybe with a couple of little extras anyway. That's August's job though, that's not really for this week, so I'll start talking to you about that as and when it happens. But then beyond that will be the release of Flix officially for PC. My Kickstarter backers, you guys are getting it first, about 8 weeks before anyone else really. I'm hoping to release it for PC, you know, not on Steam, but maybe I'll focus on a couple of particular stores if they'll have it. I'm yet to talk to anyone about doing that, so we'll see. But I'm hoping to have Flix released on PC in one place or another at the end of September, which then leads us to the PowerUp iOS at the end of October, hopefully Android end of November, and yeah, hopefully around Christmas. We'll see. As it gets further away, it gets a bit wobblier, but we'll see. Yeah, so that's for the future. In the meantime, I'm going to get on with Flix and get it to you guys who backed it. So thanks very much for doing that. Your copy of the game is in the post. All right, that was this update. I'll see you in the next one. Oh yeah, one more thing. I'm just heading up to get me wire so I can plug this phone into my computer and I can edit it. But I've just remembered, I've been going on about it loads on Twitter. But if you haven't yet, and you can't see it, do drop over to the Steam Greenlight page for Flix the Flea and give me a vote, because it's at 9% of its Steam Greenlight target. And yeah, it's picking up momentum, it's getting there. There's my wire. You know me, not one to give up over a slow start. So yeah, if you like the look of it, do back it, and I'll be eternally grateful.